Dear students, welcome to this new topic in metals and non-metals in organic synthesis. So far we have seen in this unit of metals and non-metals in organic synthesis about the mercury, boron and silicon. In silicon we have seen about the silanes as well as silanol ethers in the last lecture. Now we will see about the use of tin in organic synthesis. Tin is a versatile metal which has different oxidation states, as is the case with other metals. They have different oxidation states, and so we can use them in many different ways for carrying out our organic synthesis. Yes. Organotin compounds. And its reactions. In carbon-carbon bond formation. In carbon-carbon bond formation. In unit 2, you are studying about this tin in free radical reactions. What we have here is carbon tin jo bond formation ya bond cleavage hota hai. The carbon tin bond cleavage is generally goes through via the free radical mechanisms. So free radical mechanism ke jo bhi reactions honge, those reactions we will be studying in the unit 2. In unit 4 we will be studying about the non-free radical mechanisms. जो हमारे फ्री रेडिकल मैकेनिज्म के अलावा जो दूसरे रिएक्शंस होते हैं टिन के, दोस रिएक्शंस वी विल बी स्टडीइंग ओवर हियर. सो वी विल बी कंसंट्रेटिंग मोर ऑन ए नॉन फ्री रेडिकल, दैट इज हेट्रोलिटिक क्लीवेज ऑफ द बॉन्ड्स. वी विल बी कंसंट्रेटिंग इन दिस पर्टिकुलर यूनिट. आपका जो होमोलिटिक क्लीवेज वाला जो होता है, जो कि आपको फ्री रेडिकल्स देता है, वो आपका यूनिट 2 में आएगा. वहां पे उधर भी आपको ऑर्गेनोटिन कंपाउंड्स हैं और यहाँ पर भी ऑर्गेनोटिन कंपाउंड्स हैं, बट देयर इट विल बी फ्री रेडिकल मैकेनिज्म्स एंड हियर इट विल बी हेट्रोलिटिक क्लीवेज ऑफ द कार्बन टिन बॉन्ड्स विल बी कैरिड आउट. सो हाउ डज दैट रिएक्शन हैपेंस, दैट वी विल बी कंसंट्रेटिंग ओवर हियर. सो द सिंथेसिस ऑफ दिस ऑर्गेनोटिन कंपाउंड्स कैन बी कैरिड आउट बाय ऑक्सीडेटिव मेटलेशन. Tin, we can know that it can occur in three oxidation states. One is zero oxidation state, another is plus two oxidation state, and the third one is plus four oxidation state. So we can have three oxidation states for tin: zero, plus two and plus four. So it can be utilized for reducing other reagents also. So tin reagents are also utilized for as a reducing agents. Tin when reacted with alkyl halides at around 150 to 200 degrees Celsius, depending on which alkyl halides we are using, in presence of zinc or copper or silver as catalyst. We can use either of this as a catalyst. We will get tetraalkyl stannin and stannic chlorides or stannic halides. We will get it. This we call it as stannins. Like what we had it silanes for silicon. Similarly, this will be stannins. The stannins can also be prepared by using transmetallation reactions. Transmetallation reactions where we can use this tin halides along with Grignard reagents. और वी कैन हैव ऑर्गेनोलिथियम्स So this way you can get this particular product. Stannanes can be easily synthesized. Similarly, we can also obtain by hydrostannation. Using R3SNH, where this R3SN will be adding on one carbon and HH on the other carbon across the carbon-carbon double bond. So across the carbon-carbon double bond, you can add this hydrogen and the tin compound. So that we will get the organotin compounds can be easily obtained. Examples for this can be triphenyl stannate hydride reacted with styrene. Will be giving us pH. PH2, SN, PH thrice. Similarly, we can also prepare alkenyl tin compounds, alkenyl stannanes also. From alkynes, this will be giving us this when treated with acids. We get this particular transalkenyl stannane compound will obtain. It is usually the trans addition happens, but in certain cases it is syn addition also is preferred, but majorityly it is a trans addition that will be preferred over here. Then we can also prepare this by nucleophilic substitution. Or addition of stannyl anion whereby we will have R3SNCl reacted with two molecules of lithium, two lithium atoms, we will have R3SNLi, where now this SN or tin is having negative charge. Here tin was having positive charge and chloride was having negative charge. Now we have brought it a negative charge over here. So this can be reacting with any alkyl halides. To obtain the tetraalkyl स्टैनिन्स। सिमिलरली इट कैन ऑल्सो रिएक्ट with an aldehyde or a ketone to obtain this adduct, which upon hydrolysis, acid hydrolysis, will give us hydroxystannin. With acyl chlorides, we'll get this particular compound. Similarly, it can also react with epoxides and bring about the ring opening of epoxide. And here it will be trialkyl stannins can be easily obtained. This upon again, acid hydrolysis will give us the alcohols. The corresponding alcohols can be obtained. Similarly, it can also be utilized to react with carbon-carbon double bond. Lithium and tin will be added across the carbon-carbon double bond, which can be further protonated . So effectively, it is a addition of hydrogen and trialkyl stannin across the carbon-carbon double bond. Similarly, Michael addition type of addition can also be carried out by using this reagent. Then we will have an enolate will be which can be further hydrolyzed in dilute acidic conditions to give us enol. Which can be tautomerized . So effectively it is the addition of hydrogen and tin across the carbon-carbon double bond. So these were some of the methods of generation of stannins or organotin compounds. Now we will see about the reactions of this. First, let us see the electrophilic substitution reaction. From any source, if we are preparing this organotin compounds, those can be then further reacted with different reagents to form the desired organic compounds. First among them is electrophilic substitution reaction. We had prepared alkenyl tin compounds. This alkenyl tin compounds, if we are reacting it with an electrophile, then that electrophile will be added at the carbon which is possessing tin. So exclusively it will be added across the carbon possessing tin, so that we will have electrophile and tin added on the same carbon, and the beta carbon will be become a carbocation. This beta carbon will be carbocation, and it will be stabilized through same hyperconjugation effect that was present for the silyl carbocations also. This carbocation is a stabilized carbocation. Stabilized carbonium ion. Now this can lose this tin, trialkyl tin, along with here if we have a counter ion, and that counter ion will also be lost, and we will get a carbon-carbon double bond. Usually the addition is with the same stereochemistry that was for the organo tin compound, so there is no change in the orientation of the incoming group. Examples can be we can have an acetyl chloride, where the acetyl group is the electrophile here in presence of lewis acid. We have a positive charge, carbon possessing acetyl group. And trialkyl tin. This is stabilized by AlCl4 minus counter ion. This will be losing the trialkyl tin. So you get an alpha beta unsaturated ketone. Will be obtained, and the AlCl3 will be regenerated back. So these alpha beta unsaturated ketones can be easily generated using this particular method. Similarly, we can carry out the reaction with an alpha beta unsaturated acyl chloride. Final product will be this particular product. We will get it as a final product here. Similarly, this can also be reacted with in presence of PiCl3, PiCl4. You get the product as this particular compound as the product. There can be many different such reactions can be carried out where the electrophile can be added across the carbon-carbon double bond processing film. Then we can have reactions with allyl. Organotene compounds or allyl stannins, reactions of allyl stannins, so tin is at the allylic position to the carbon-carbon double bond, so here this is alpha, beta and gamma, so there will be addition across this beta, gamma and then electrophile will be attacking this gamma carbon and not the alpha carbon of the allylic position. We will have the electrophile getting attached to the gamma carbon and beta carbon will be having positive charge. So that carbocation at beta position is stabilized through hyperconjugation of the tin. This can be further the tin or a trialkyl tin can be lost. We will get this particular compound and trialkyl tin with the counteract. So this can be looked as similar to if tin is being lost and this electrophile is added across the alpha, but as there is a resonance effect, it will be added across the gamma carbon and not at the alpha carbon. Examples of this can be here if we have a SNR3, this is reacting with benzoyl chloride. We will get this particular product. This is not an alpha beta unsaturated ketone, but it is at the allylic or beta carbon to the ketone is having beta gamma carbon is having double bond. Alpha beta unsaturated ketones can be generated from alkenyl tin compounds. Similarly, from here we will get to know that it is the gamma position that is attacked and not the ipso carbon, ipso type of carbon or the carbon possessing tin. So our final attack will be something like this and not the acetyl group being added over here, the carbon possessing tin. अगर डायरेक्ट उसी कार्बन पर हो रहा होता रिएक्शन जैसे कि अल्किनिल्स में होता था हमारा ये ऊपर के जो इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शंस देखे थे तो वहां पर जिस कार्बन पे टिन अटैच्ड है उसी कार्बन पर रिएक्शन हो रहा था यहां पे वो कार्बन पर रिएक्शन नहीं हो रहा है उसके गामा कार्बन पर रिएक्शन हो रहा है. सो दैट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द एलिलिक एलील स्टैनिंस एंड द एल्किनिल स्टैनिंस. दोनों में रिएक्टिविटीज डिफरेंट होती हैं. सो दैट वी हैव टू लुक इट इन टू दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग. सिमिलरली माइकल टाइप रिएक्शन कैन ऑल्सो बी डन. Whereby if we have a alpha beta unsaturated ketone reacting with now what we can say is that this double bond is attacking the gamma carbon of alpha beta unsaturated ketone. This double bond will be moving over here and this oxygen will be attacking the tin. Oxygen will be attacking the tin and this double bond will be moving over, or this or carbon tin bond will be moving for formation of a double bond. So overall reaction will be, it will be, bond will be generated over here, double bond possessing an oxygen with alkyl tin. यहाँ पे मेरा मिथिल ग्रुप. इस तरफ में we will have this and double bond. So ये हमारा reaction होगा. This if we are doing acid hydrolysis. So you will get an enol. This enol can be tautomerized. So give us this particular ketone, a Michael addition added ketone can be generated. So a Michael type addition reactions can also be carried out in this particular way. Similarly, we can do the halogenolysis or protonolysis also. Protonolysis and halogenolysis can be carried out if we have, say, R4 tin, that is tetraalkyl tin, reacted with an acid. It will have an RH and R3 SNH will be generated. Similarly, if we have a tetraalkyl tin when reacted with say bromine molecule, it will have alkyl bromide. R3SNBr will be generated. The organotin compounds are, organotins are stable to water and alcohol. So its reactions can be carried out in water and alcohol, but they react with phenols, mercaptans, that is thiols. Thiols के साथ ये react करते हैं. Mercaptans we call it as thiols. Then acids, organic acids. So they will be reacting with this. So we cannot carry out the reactions of organotin in phenols or thiols as a solvent. And the acids. Here the reactions will be, they are tetraalkyl tin when reacted with phenol, will get RH and RPSNOPH. Phenoxide ion will be added to the film. Similarly, if we are reacting it with say an acid, we will have RH
plus
R dash CO dialkyl chain. Similarly, if we are reacting it with mercaptans, this requires little heating. We get RH and R dash SNR. So these reactions can be easily been carried out with this. Similarly, the last reaction of this tin, organic tin compounds, is the oxidation with CrO3. Oxidation with CrO3, that is organotin compounds are converted to alcohols or carbonates if they possess hydrogen at the carbon possessing tin, then they will be converted to carbonyls. If they do not have hydrogen on the carbon possessing tin, then it will be only alcohols will be generated. The reaction, general reaction for this will be like if we have this as an organo tin compound and we are reacting it with CrO3 in pyridine, that will be generating chromic acid HCrO4. So this chromic acid can react two minus. So this will be generated here. This will be reacting with this, so we will get R3CO minus, which can be converted with protonation to R3COH, that is alcohol can be generated, and we will have R3SNOCRO or CrO2. Examples for this can be tertiary butyl dialkyl pin when reacted with CrO3 in pyridine. We will get carbon. Oxygen plus R3SNCRO. As it was the carbon possessing pin was not having any hydrogens, so it will stop over there. Lekin agar yahan pe hydrogens hote hain, like for example, in this particular case, यहाँ पे ये टिन का ये जो कार्बन है यहाँ पर एक हाइड्रोजन है. तो व्हेन वी आर सब्जेक्टिंग दिस टू CrO3 पिरिडीन, दिस विल बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू कीटोन. जो अल्कोहल बनेगा वो अल्कोहल फिर सेकेंडरी अल्कोहल होगा एंड दैट विल बी ऑक्सीडाइज्ड अगेन विद कीटोन. ये वाला अल्कोहल कीटोन को नहीं होता है बिकॉज इट इज अ टर्शियरी. This alcohol और tin को छोड़ने के बाद यहाँ पे जो OH आएगा, that is a secondary alcohol, So it will be oxidized to ketone. The other one will not be. Similarly, we have studied about the adamantane. This is our adamantane, and if it is an organo, tin compound generated. This then subjected to CrO3 in pyridine. This carbon is tertiary carbon now, so it will not have any hydrogen attached to it, and hence it will be generating only alcohol. A tertiary alcohol will be generated. So this way we can create the reactions of organophene compounds. We can synthesize organophene compounds and we can react them also.